reading the 8th to the 20th verses. Let us pray. Spirit of the living God. Spirit of the living God. Fall fresh. On this edifice right now. Fall fresh on each and every one of us assembled here. Take my mind, my heart, and my intellect. And with all your impulses, move and wing it from earth. And then if you will, Lord, speak. Speak, Lord. For your humble servant listens and is ready and willing to do thy will.
Christ's birth
and for his death on the cross was to pay the penalty for our sins. To celebrate his birth, we must change our mindset. The Magi knew that the gifts they traveled afar with, Jesus was worthy of them. They knew that the star they followed was the signal of Jesus' birth. And for the worship to begin to allow us to be led by the Holy Spirit forever. The Magi set the tone for how the celebration of Christmas should be carried out and held. As soon as they saw the star, they made it a priority to pursue the Lord, following the star, traveling to worship Jesus. Mm-hmm. If you will, let us visit the humble message of the first Christmas. It looks nothing like what we imagine. No shopping or excitement. No food or partying. No snow. No decorated lights or trees. There's simply a group of shepherds, lowly and unclean. Yet they were the ones God chose for the most important birth announcement in history. And also of humanity. What kind of message was this that was given to these shepherds which changed the world forever? You all pray for me and with me for a few moments and I'll be out your way. Wild worship. First of all, it was a heavenly message. Our text states that an angel of the Lord suddenly out of nowhere stood before the shepherds. And the glory of God shone all around them. And they were terribly frightened. This angel was unusual. Unusual as the birth of Christ. We recall that in our Bibles, when God had a message for the people, he usually sent a prophet. But this message was so important that he sent word directly from heaven by his angel. Oh, I wish somebody would hear me this evening. The glory of God that accompanied this angel was manifested in radiant, dazzling light and confirmed that this message was coming directly from heaven. The first Christmas was announced as a heavenly event, a miracle in the midst of nothing that changed the world. Signaling that we should worship Jesus on his birthday eternally, as often as possible. Right. Amen?
Amen?
Secondly, the angel's message and announcement was a universal message. Scripture says, the angel said, I bring you good news of great joy, which will be for all people. For in the city of David, there has been born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. This was a universal message for every person on earth and throughout time. This baby would open the way of salvation for all people. The angel identified the baby, Jesus, with three other titles. Says he is called the Savior. He is called the Christ, or I, Messiah. Through his divinity, the shepherds knew that they had not been diverted from their mission. They knew they had found our Savior to be worshipped, signaling eternal worship unto Jesus. Thirdly, this angelic message announced peace. It states, suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among all men whom he has pleased. The peace the angel announced surpasses all of our understanding. However, once Jesus was crucified, that kind of peace will only come when he returns. This is why we worship him, because the peace and the saving grace he offers only comes with him. It is from the presence of his indwelling Holy Spirit we receive his blessings when we worship him. However, his peace is for everyone who worships and receives him as their Savior. They become people with whom he is pleased. Finally, we find out this message from the angel was meant to be shared. After the shepherds went to see the baby Jesus, they made a statement which had been told to them about Jesus. This announcement they could not keep to themselves, because the hope of mankind was lying in that manger. This baby and manger was God's way to bring salvation to all. The birth of Jesus took away all the mixed feelings life gives and turns them into healing joy and renewed strength. To run this race, patience to see him face to face after living and serving mankind. Jesus bore our sins and gave us eternal life. And because of that, we should worship him and praise him, because soon and very soon he shall appear. He said, it is word that I go to prepare a place for you, and when I return, there you shall be also with me forever. But you must be ready and born again. So let us not get caught up not ready or unborn. Let us worship Jesus for all the wonderful and marvelous works he has performed in our lives. Let us worship for him, for he has been good, better to us than we've been to ourselves. Let us worship Jesus, for in the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. In the name of Jesus, every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord and King of Kings. We must worship him, for he is the reason for this season. For when he shall come with trumpet sound, may I be found dressed in his righteousness and able to say, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and his righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but hold and lean on Jesus' name. Church, let us worship him, for he is the reason for this season. God bless you.
Amen. Amen.